I'm aware that all that information is relevant for our investigation, and all that will be taken into account. I mean, I work at our Ministry of Foreign Affairs, and I can tell you from day one of this crisis, we've had open phones with the UN, very good coordination. We said from the outset that we want to keep the UN people on the ground.
Oh, take a photo, for God's sake, woman! What are you doing?
Neil.
How exactly happened, why it happened, has to be discussed.
No, sorry.
You also have to ask the following question. I mean, was Hezbollah deliberately firing from an area next to a UN phone? And I'm not justifying anything that we did, but I think it's important to put the question to it. Was there not a danger here that Hezbollah was firing from that area, thinking that they would find that area to be a safe haven, as the UN has said, as they hide behind Lebanese civilians all too often?
Mike Ringer, this is not the first time UN posts along the Blue Line have been targeted. Last week, we were told by the UN Chief of Staff, Major General Clive Lilly, that four UN bases along the Blue Line had had close shaves and some had taken direct hits. Are you absolutely convinced this is not a way of telling the UN observers to get out of the way? The Israeli military is here and they have an operation to do, but they don't want independent observers there.
I think the jumper's dead, Ruby.
We are facilitating a cooperative relationship with the UN. We've done everything we can to safeguard the UN position. We have a dialogue with the UN, just as I said before, Kofi Annan spoke earlier today with my Prime Minister, Mr. Olmert. We see the UN as part of the solution for Lebanon. We say the whole time, let's finally implement UN Security Council Resolution 1559, which talks about disarming the Hezbollah military machine. I think that's all the things we want to do. There's no logical reason that you could bring up and could say why Israel would deliberately try to hit a UN target. It just makes no sense.
I don't want to be parochial here, but there are still a number of Australian troops wearing the blue beret in southern Lebanon. Can you guarantee that they won't be hit by Israeli airstrike?
I can say the following unequivocally. No person wearing a UN beret is a target for Israeli airstrike. We do not deliberately target innocent citizens, nor do we target the UN. And I want to say something about Australia, if you're already bringing up that issue. I had a meeting earlier today with the Australian ambassador, and we just received from him praise as to the amount of cooperation he was getting from my government in helping to bring about the safe exit of those 45,000 Australian citizens who were caught up in Lebanon. And I think it's a sign of the good relationship between our country. We've been on the phone with the Australian embassy and other Australian officials, I think 24 hours a day, 7 days a week until this problem has been solved. We're working and we continue to work. Obviously, if we can help get Australians out of the danger zone, we will do so.
Okay, how can you explain the attack on Sunday night, reportedly by an Apache...